Well, it was a good weekend for Lady Vols softball. Good to finally play some games and to open the season at home, have our home debut. Really proud of the way we swung the bats. We got a lot better as the weekend went along. A little rusty Friday night after a 13-day layoff, but I thought we got better every game this weekend and finished really strong on Sunday. I honestly didn't know that it was approaching until I happened to walk through my office as Megan Gregg was being interviewed on Friday, I believe it was, and somebody was asking her about it. And I went, oh, okay. And I know it's going to sound cliche, but it means two things. You've been coaching a long time, and you've had some really outstanding players, because players win games. So really, you know, fortunate to be able to coach at some great institutions that support softball, UT Chattanooga and University of Tennessee, that give us the resources to build winning programs and to go out and recruit some outstanding young softball players, and have been blessed with just some great young women to come through these programs.
What does just getting five games in on the weekend at home do for you? Forget winning and the margin you won by, just but putting them all together like that.
Well, that 2 weeks was unlike anything we've ever been through, because, you know, in January, you get to the last 2 weeks of January before you know you're going to open your season, and it's always hard because your kids are so anxious to play. They're just tired of practicing. That time of year, you end up going indoors some because of the weather, and you're just itching to see somebody in a different uniform, but you know when opening day is coming, and then you know you're going to be playing games a lot. Well, that 2 weeks was hard because you didn't know it was going to be 2 weeks. You kept hoping and thinking you were going to play. If we had known we were going to have a two-week layoff, we probably would have given the team 4 days off at the beginning of it and then come back and gotten ready again to play. But because you don't know how long it's going to be, you keep practicing, hoping and hoping, and that's what made it so difficult. So it was certainly nice to get some weather that we could play in and get back on the track that we want to be on, which is playing ball. Well, actually, there were only two teams that ended up really being affected by it. Yeah, us and Kentucky that completely were, well, we were the only one completely wiped out that one weekend. Kentucky was able to salvage a doubleheader at Tennessee Tech. But everybody else was playing somewhere where they could get their games in. So if you look at total games played, we're down there right now. Missouri doesn't have as many games played, but that's by choice. They never play the first weekend. Yeah, they just choose not to play the first weekend that we're allowed to play. So we're probably most impacted by what happened, and it's just because we had scheduled to host and had bad weather.
How much of a concern is that going? I guess SEC plays about a week and a half away now, just in terms of being as prepared as you'd like to be? Or,
you know, it's the hand we're dealt, so we're not going to spend any time dwelling on it or talking about it. You know, we're just going to hopefully used our advantage all the practice time we were able to get in during those 2 weeks, and you know, get lemons and you turn it into lemonade. That's what you try to do, and you just try to turn everything into a positive with your team. Well, I think two things happened with Megan Gregg. One, Ralph spent a lot of time with Megan working on adjustments in her swing and just making sure that she was taking her hands away and getting her front foot down on time. And I think that work really paid off. And then the second thing is we just sort of forced the issue with Megan in terms of her role in our batting order and the responsibility. We recruited Megan to hit at the top of the order, and she got off to a bit of a slow start, so we moved her down in the lineup. But I think sometimes when you do that, kids can kind of hide down there. And we just sort of said, you know what, we don't care that you're batting 179. You were meant to be at the top of the order. We believe in you as a hitter who can hit at the top of the order for us. We want you to take this and run with it. And I think when Ralph told her that, it gave her a lot of confidence, just knowing that we really believed in her regardless of the start that she had had. And you saw this weekend what Megan Gregg can do. I don't think Megan's going to hit 688 all season, and we're certainly not saying that, but Megan Gregg's a very special player.
Let's talk about South Carolina and what the keys might be
Yeah, well, we're going to look forward, not look back. South Carolina is a rising program. Bev's in her, I think, fifth year now with that program, and every year they've gotten better. They're a team that has been to regionals the last 3 years. They're really trying to crack that top half of the SEC, and they're recruiting better and better players. It's going to be a very competitive series. I think our teams are evenly matched in a lot of ways. What's key for us is to become more consistent in having quality at bats throughout our lineup and throughout the game. What we did this weekend, and we got a little bit better at each game, was having quality at bats, but we still had some breakdowns. And we spent a lot of time in those 2 weeks charting our pitch selection and looking at our efficiency with our at bats and what we were doing with different pitches and the pitches we're taking, the pitches we're swinging at. And I think it really opened our kids' eyes to what they needed to work on. And we made some improvement this weekend, but we're still not consistent throughout our lineup and throughout the game.
Coach, I saw where you added two extra matchups, a doubleheader against Illinois State tomorrow, and then March 25th matchup against Tennessee Tech. Can you talk a little bit about why you guys added those games and how they're going to help your team going forward?
Well, we lost those five games from the tournament, and then potentially a couple other single games that we've postponed, and we're hoping that we can play down the road with Georgia Tech and Virginia Tech, but certainly those five from the tournament are gone completely. So we're trying to reschedule games or add some games to the schedule to pick those ones up. So the doubleheader tomorrow night, we'll get one game there with that starting at 5 o'clock, and then picking up a game with Tennessee Tech, that's another one. You want to play 56 games, and you know that just helps your kids, because at the end of the season, I think that prepares you more for postseason play when you've had enough games under your belt, and also puts your kids in the best position to win postseason honors. It's not really fair to them when other teams have 56-game schedule and numbers from 56 games, and you might only have played 50 or 51. So we want to get as many games in as we can, you know, under the rules.
But there is a possibility more midweek games could be added then.
It's possible. The challenge is, we pretty much had a midweek game every week during our entire season. And when you put two midweek games in there, it's, you know, you're adding quite a bit to the load in any given week. But in a lot of cases, I think our kids would rather play a game than practice. So as long as we're not traveling for those midweeks, we'll try to add a midweek where we can.
Is there an area of the game that develops more in this pre-conference part of the schedule that now falls behind because you missed so many innings? Is it hitting? Is it pitching? Is it just being out there competing against another team? Is there any area of the game that falls behind if you just don't get the opportunity to play?
I think it's pitching. I think that's the part that you want to see your pitchers in live situations, and you can learn a lot from when you can get them out there in live situations. And as I think about it now, you know, we knew we were going to have to pitch by committee this year, and I would feel a whole lot more comfortable going into SEC play right now if we had a few more games under our belt where we could really test that philosophy and test that theory. This weekend will be interesting, you know, going against South Carolina, because that'll be our first real opportunity to do that. So, and now that we have Cheyenne Tarango back and she's getting healthier, getting back in shape, our first chance to have four pitchers to pitch by committee. But that's the part that I think has been affected the most with not being able to play the games and play the games back to back to back, which is what you have to do in an SEC series.